Okay, students, come to the next problem. The topic is journal entries. And come to the problem, journalize the following transactions. And it is the owner or the proprietor is Jayalakshmi. So write at the top in the books of Jayalakshmi. Next line you write journal entries. Now come to the first. Commenced business with cash, furniture and machinery. So first you have to see what are the things involved in it. Whenever you commence the business, we are in the capital. The cash, furniture and the machinery. Capital is a liability, and whenever there is a introduction of the business or when you are introducing the business, the capital is increasing. Increase in the capital is credit. Come to the next. Cash, furniture and machinery are all of the assets. So when you are investing in it, increase in the asset is debt. So the journal entry will be, what is debit? First should be written. Write the date 1/5/2020. Cash account debtor, furniture account debtor, machinery account debtor, to capital account. And the cash is 50,000. Write it in the debit column. If you are written it as BR, write it in the debit column. Furniture 10,000. Machinery 40,000. Total it up, that will be 1 lakh. Write it in the credit column corresponding to the capital. Now write the narration. Narration is nothing but it is a brief explanation. Commence business with the above. Come to the next. Bought furniture 5,000 for office use. You are purchasing the furniture for the office use. The word office use has nothing to do. You are purchasing the furniture, is the name of the asset. And it is a cash transaction, so the word cash is there. Cash is an asset. When you are purchasing the furniture, you will have to pay the cash. Decrease in the asset is credit. Furniture is an asset, you are purchasing it. Increase in the furniture is debit. And so the entry will be furniture account debtor to furniture account better to cash account. And the amount is 5,000. Write the narration. Bought furniture. For office use. And write the bill. 5,500. Come to the next. Withdrew cash 1,000 and use 2,000 for personal use. Withdrew, that is cash and use, and you are using it for the personal use. We call it as a drawings. Now, drawings is a capital. Drawings is a capital. Okay. Come to the word cash. You are withdrawing from the business. You are withdrawing from the business, and whenever there is a decrease in the asset, it is a credit. Even the goods, that is nothing but the purchases, we use the word. We do not use the word goods. And whenever you are withdrawing it for your personal use, it is a credit. And drawings will be the debit. Come to the next. Because you are withdrawing from the business and your capital is decreasing, so the entry will be drawings account debtor to cash account to purchases account and the date is 14/5/20. So you are withdrawing 1000 cash and you are withdrawing 2000 the goods. Whenever the word goods is there, use the word purchases, and total of that is the drawings. What you are doing that is 3000. Write the narration withdrew for personal use. Come to the next. Paid for advertisement 800 and printing 500. Whenever it is paid, it means you are paying the cash. Next is advertising and printing. Cash is asset. You are paying for it. When you pay for it, there is a decrease in the cash, decrease in the asset, and it is credit. Advertising and printing are the expenses. Increase in the expenses is debit. So the entry will be advertising account debtor or advertisement account debtor. Printing account debtor. To cash account. Write the amount. Advertising is 800 and printing is 500. Total it, write in the credit column 1300. Write the narration paid for the amount. The date is 2018. Come to the next. Sold goods rupees 5000 to Rajesh and received cash 2000. So you are selling the goods. Use the word sales. And you are selling the goods. Total it is 5000 to Rajesh. And out of that 5000 you are receiving 2000. It means remaining 3000 is a credit money. Come to the word sales. Sales is an income for you. Increase in the income is a credit. Increase in the income is a credit. Next, cash. You are receiving the cash. When the cash is increasing, it is a debit. Next, come to Rajesh. Rajesh is a debtor and the increase in the debtor is a debit. So the entry will be cash account debtor Rajesh account debtor to sales account. Write the narration sold goods and the date is 25th. So total sales are 5000. Out of that 2000 you are receiving. It means credit sales are 2000. Come to the next. Received cash from Anita 7000. In full settlement of your account 7500. So the things involved are cash, Anita, full settlement means it is a discount. So I had told you in the earlier class, if cash is debited, discount also will be debited. If cash is credited, discount also will be credited. Come to the cash. You are receiving the cash. Increase in the asset is debit. So automatically discount also is debited. Anita was our debtor. Decrease in the debtor is credit because it is an asset. Decrease in the asset is credit. So the entry is cash account debtor discount account debtor to to Anita's account. The date is 28. Write the narration. Received cash. Totally you should receive is 7500. Write it in the credit column. You have received 7000 cash and 500 is the discount. Come to the next. Bought goods from Nirmal on credit 10,000 and cash 4,000. Bought means it is a purchases. So whenever it is credit transaction, the name of the person should appear, that is Nirmal, and the word cash. So increase in the purchases. Purchases is an expenditure for you. Whenever it is an increase in the purchases, it is debit. Come to the cash. Whenever you are purchasing, you are paying the cash. Decrease in the asset is credit. Come to the Nirmal. And he is the creditor for you. Increase in the creditors is credit. And the entry will be purchases account creditor. To Nirmal's account. Cash account. Write the narration. Purchase the goods. And the date is 30th. So you are purchasing the goods. 10,000 is on credit. And cash is 4,000. Total purchases are 14,000. Come to the next. Pay the Nirmal rupees 5,000 in full settlement of his account 10,000. Paid means it is cash. Nirmal full settlement means it is a discount. So when you are paying, decrease in the cash is credit. Next. Whenever cash is credit, discount also is credit. Come to Nirmal. He was our creditor. Decrease in the creditor is a debit. And so the entry will be Nirmal's account debtor. To cash account. To discount account. Write the narration, paid cash. And the date is 31. So, total payment what you are giving to Nirmal is 9,500. Write it for the cash. 500 is the discount. And total amount you have to pay to Nirmal is 10,000. So, these are the journal entries, students. I told you in the earlier class, if there are two or more than two debits or credits, we call it as compound.